Hey guys, Abhishek here, and today I'll be posting a full review of the Cooler Master Notepad L1 which I bought via Flipkart for around 700 rupees. I've been using this for around 1 week now daily and it has done a damn good job for me for the price of 700 rupees. First of all, having a look at the design, on the box it says that it's ergonomically designed. So if you see from the sides, we have some slants on left as well as the right hand side. I guess that would be mainly in order to centralize the airflow to the central bottom of a laptop. And if you see from the sides, it's kind of a slanted. I guess this might be so that it would handle 9-cell laptops with 9-cell batteries pretty good as well. Considering the screen size up to which it supports, you can basically have laptops up to 15.6 inch in screen size mounted on it. On front we have the mesh, and below the mesh we have the 106 cm fan. Do note that the mesh is made of metal, and on the back we have a plastic material. It's kind of a matte material, I'll say. And over here we have a bar for cable management. As you can see, you can just tuck this port onto over here, so whenever you're not using it, your cable is not like lying down around. Secondly, moving on to the weight of this Cooler Master Notepad L1, it's pretty lightweight, I'll say. Its weight might not be exceed maybe 500 grams or so. And moving on to the fan, it's a 106 cm fan, as I said earlier, and it does a great job cooling the laptop. A minor con that I felt about this fan is that it's silent, but it's not still ultra silent. Whenever you are playing a game or a movie, you won't hear it sound, but if you like casually are just browsing the web or doing anything else, you will definitely hear some sound from the fan. Speaking about the fan, another thing I'd like to say is that even if you won't feel the speed when you place your hand over the fan, it does a pretty good job cooling your laptop. At start, even I was not impressed with the fan, but later on when I started checking the temperature on the laptop, I mean the bottom surface of the laptop, I was quite impressed with the fan. So I'll say that you won't feel the speed of the fan, but it does definitely do a great job. Having a look at its USB port, as you can see, it has a port on the back as well, so you can just connect another device on the back and still use this Cooler Master Notepad L1. So consider that you have two USB ports on your device and you have connected a pen drive to one, and another USB port is busy with this Notepad L1. You can just connect another USB device. Consider that you want to use your mouse and you can just plug it in and you don't experience any problem. Even I had connected my mouse and I didn't experience any problem with this. So it's a pretty good feature on the Notepad L1. I must say that it's not wasting your USB port. The only con that I felt about the Cooler Master Notepad L1 is about its fan. Even though it's a 106 cm fan, the centerpiece of the motor is quite big for its size. If it would have been smaller, it could have done a more great cooling, and it could have also increased the efficiency. They could have also installed a 180 mm fan, but I guess that could have increased the price of the L1. So in conclusion, I'll say that the Cooler Master Notepad L1 is probably the best cooling pad you can get for 700 rupees, and I will say that it has kept the reputation of the company, that is Cooler Master, intact. I'm quite impressed with it, and even though it's my first cooling pad, I'll stick on to it for a pretty long time, I'll say. It does a pretty great job, and I don't think that you need to spend an excess of say 700 or 800 rupees buying a cooling pad. This is a pretty great one, and I'll definitely suggest it to anyone else who is in search for cooling pads. So I guess that's it for this video. Thank you for watching, and if you do like the video, do hit the like button and also do subscribe to my channel. I'll be posting many such videos really soon. Thank you.